I want that roll. I'm guessing I want to draw. Ooh, this hand is great. It has all my combos. I'm definitely keeping. The question is, do I want to try to set this up? Or do I just want to jam this in turn two and start attacking? There is a cost to playing this in turn two. I don't charge my land. So if I play on turn two, then turn three I charge, and turn four I charge, and turn five I play Kaga. But I can't second. Or the alternative is I charge turn two, charge turn three, charge turn four, and then I play this, and then I can control magic. Problem is that if I don't, I'm never gonna play this temple if I don't play turn one. Say I play swamp plains, then next turn I play crucible, then turn four I play temple. I think this is better. I mean, I can reevaluate now and play the crucible with. Sorry, play something else. Now I really want a black source, which means I probably want to play the temple on turn three. I guess I'll just jam this. And just forget this crucible. And he mulliganed to five, and I drew a Kalidas. Maybe I can just kill him. Well, that he already got back his mulligan between Rakdos, Karnaryu, and Night's Whisper, so. I think I just want to play the crucible here. Like, it speeds my Kaga by one turn, so it's not the end of the world if I brick here. I pass because, like, vector fiction or something? This is the only land that I would consider keeping, but I don't think I want it. Oh wow. I'm so great! Arrange the cards into piles. Okay, so what does this do? Yeah, no, not bad. That's a good one to steal. What does this do? Not bad either. The two lands should probably go together with maybe the satchel. All right, let's do this. Okay, maybe I should delay my Kaga for a turn here then. Because I can just play it and sack it immediately. What? This card is great. I think I should just play this. There can't be that many exile effects, right? And if he plays a bounce spell, I have Vile anyway to block. Alright, I'm doing that. Remove two. Really? Alright, so if he doesn't exile it, I think I'm in fine shape. If he does exile it, then I'm actually in a bit of trouble. Because he's gonna attack, I'll have to trade. I guess he can't play that demon devil thing immediately. Maybe my sorting wasn't good, the factor fiction thing. Maybe those were the two good cards and I put them both together. I don't know, it was a really good factor fiction. I'm not really good, it was a good factor fiction. There was nothing obvious that he needed, but a lot of cards that maybe he would want. Like, the satchel is... will go pretty long. I mean, I have to block with Kaga here, I think. I could block with Eileen. That leaves him free range to just kill Kaga, though. So what is more like, does he have a damage-based spell? If I block and he just deals one damage to Kaga, that's bad for me. But if I block here and he just terrors my Kaga, I could also take it. Then he will probably kill... I think blocking with Kaga is better. I mean, it depends on what he has, but I think at least this, the worst case scenario is I lose Kaga. I mean, I guess the worst case scenario is he plays a sweeper, like a Languish. That would be very annoying. But I think it's more likely that he has something like a Doomblade than a Languish. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe it isn't. Like, because now he has a Lightning Bolt. Oh, wow. That's annoying. I mean, I guess he could have just paid 5, so it wouldn't have mattered. So he's going to play the Demon guy next turn. It's gonna kill my Chandra. I think I should play it anyway. Because I don't have another black source to play Antacta, so I would have to draw another black source. You know, I don't have many that can play untap to begin with. That was a very bad draw. It doesn't actually kill this. If I play Kalidas, that does nothing. I can't really play anything. That sucks. You can just pay one and kill this, but there's nothing I can do about it. Should I play a land? I don't think I should play a land. Because I want to be able to play on Sectors if I draw Swamp. This card is broken. Why didn't I take it? Oh, he didn't pump it? Okay. He could have. Right? He just gets minus O minus X and. Swamp? Oh, good enough. This is not a dragon, right? Vampire, Shaman, Devil. Okay. Now I probably want to play land. The plains or the harbor? Harbor will come to play tapped, but plains will let me charge the crucible. I'll go with plains. Black creature. That doesn't do anything. Oh, I didn't charge my land. Oops. I mean, I guess I could just play Kalidas here. Probably this too. I think Kalidas is probably better. I'm going to play some non-black creatures. Alright. Should I play this one instead? I'm not sure. I mean, this is lethal next turn. Assuming no shenanigans. He plays it. Yeah, he has a removal spell, then it's not lethal, obviously. It's good that he doesn't know that it's lethal. He probably shouldn't expect me to be able to pump anything. What the hell? Draw a card too? That's stupid. Probably no reason to play any of those. What did he do with his top card? I didn't even see any. He kept it. Bottom, okay. Oh, I probably should have played a land, so I could play Illishorn and sack this. That would have been better. Yeah, I think that was a mistake. Oh. Rewarded. So do I want to attack first? Because if he has a counterspell, then I die if I attack. You also have something like a Prophetic Bolt or something else that is just 4 damage. But he would have killed it immediately, I think. When I couldn't sack it. Am I winning if he has a counterspell? That's very unlikely, because there is no way. Like, I have to Yeah, I like attacking. I don't die as a counter spell because I can sack this and take only 3 damage. So I think it's better to attack first. Oh, I tap all my black. I will die if he has a counter spell. That was stupid. I just didn't. Oh my god, that was so bad. Oh, is it likely dead anyway? Well, maybe not. This is infuriating. I hate when I do things like this. It's just up in unknown basic lands. They all look the same to me. It's just, I just assume that I have all the colors I could possibly want. Do I want this? It seems like everyone has so many removal spells. I can submit it like this. Nope, not playing first. Interesting hand. 2 chances to draw a land. No removal. I don't know. I think I should mulligan. Probably don't want it. Ooh, look at a sick combo. Probably want this. Maybe I should have taken this out. Probably not. I mean, he played 3 creatures last game and 2 were whack, but that doesn't mean his creatures are all black. Now, if he passes with a blue land, should I run this into private? That's a moot point, but. Oh, that's annoying. This card's very good. I should have taken it. I already had so many though. I don't play many turn 2 mana things in this draft. Oh wow, he does have Prophetic Vault. The deck is sweet. Probably just play a monster. Other alternative is playing Eile and cycling this and returning it. Which wouldn't be awful, but it's kind of on the low end of things. I think I'd prefer just getting a guy in play. Maybe get some damage in. I don't know if that corpse had something. Not that one. I guess I can swing past it. And that's probably all I can do. I guess I can just kill it. And I probably will. It's probably blocking, I imagine. He can't think that saving me a mana is worth saving him 6 life. Oh wow, he took it. He's gonna make him discard a card with Funeral Charm. That would be really bad. I needed a white land. Oh, I guess I'll keep breathing one thing at a time. All right, 11. Ooh, finally it's enough that I can kill. Do I even want to? Probably. He has 2. It has to be worth it. I have 10 damage here with my Haven and Kokusho. So I'm definitely in a good spot. That one. Should I Wrath it? What can he get back? Prohibit or Prophetic Bolt? Prophetic Bolt is so good to get back. I should just play Kokusho. Prohibit is not gonna do anything. Unseen Cravens might kill him, so Prophetic Bolt is the best thing to get back. If Prophetic Bolt's my Kokusho, the Legends for 1. I think playing Kokusho is better. You can also like exclude me or something, and that would be very annoying, but. That's bad. I mean, I don't know what he has. It might not be awful. At least he can get a teaching back now, which probably better than he can get a prophetic bow. Tainted pact? It's not even good. Oh. God damn it. That was lucky. Yeah. Do I want to block with Kukusha or with a token? Probably with Kukusha. Maybe not. If I block with Kukusha, he bolts me, kills Kukusha, and goes to 6. Huh. I don't know if slowing this game down is better for me or not. It probably is. I mean, if I get one hit in, then I just play a guy, then next turn he attacks again. Did I force him to perfect build this turn? Well, no, he has a tainted effect, I can just cast that instead. I think blocking with Eldrazi token is better. If he didn't have Tainted Pact, maybe. Because that would force him to pay much, a lot of mana, but eh. What is happening? Do I want to get Kukusha back immediately? Or do I want to play Ojutai next turn? I guess getting it back can't be bad. Yeah, getting it back has to be better. Because then I can play, the next turn I can attack and kill it, and I kill him, but I assume he doesn't have a convenient way to deal with it, otherwise he just cast it. I probably shouldn't have cycled in first. I could get 4 spiked. I don't know if 4 spike is in this thing, but yeah, this is better because then I can just play Ojutai and attack with it and tap something if it comes to that. So it's not like I lose anything. Stop tapping millions of mana. Jesus. Okay. Well, I guess I have to do it. If she has a counter spell, I'm dead. He has a counter spell in his deck, I'm probably dead. Because he has Tainted Pact. But I don't see many alternatives. I could just pass and not attack, but that's him so loose. Oh, I could pass. No, he's not gonna obtain it back to the end of the turn. Then that would just let him teachings for the counter spell. But I think if he had a counter spell, he would have just searched for that immediately. Alright. I probably want the same things. Well, I want Russian knowledge. I don't know if I want Russian knowledge. Maybe instead of Elishnorn? That's just a big door. Like, it doesn't seem. Yeah. That seems okay. 5 mana draw two. I guess. Oh, maybe I should have Burn Away. Yeah, Burn Away seems better actually. Do I want a Mountain then? I have a Plateau and Thunderstone will add red. I don't think I need it. Yeah, that seems better. It kills the black guys that I can't kill with Carve Snatch. Ooh, turn two chase. It's neat. What? Alright, that's not that bad. I guess he could just play that 4/4 next turn and destroy me. I can actually flip my Jace though. That's pretty cool. If I draw a land. This is what I don't want. Okay, I thought I was actually getting four spike now. Ooh, that is good with Satchel. You just put a land into play. It's a broken combo. It's even untapped. That is kind of a broken combo. This guy seems good against him. 5/8 is so hard to kill. So I have one card in my river, it'd be 2/3. So yeah, probably have to alchemy, then not sack that bubble. What is this card? I didn't know it. Never seen it before. Question is, do I want to loot? Or do I want to keep a Jace? Or. I guess I don't care about flipping the Jace right now. I'm just going to pass the turn and make my decision later. I assume he's putting a land into play here. Anything else would be quite bad. Oh, he might just not have a land. Oh, he exiled that? Does he just want a land? Well, he knew what it was. Ooh, Exile's Island? An island. I don't understand. Is Exile two islands? Then Bricked, what was he looking for? This is so weird. Okay, that one I'm killing. I guess I will get swamp. And charge my thingy. Oh, I guess I'll draw a card first. This is probably what I don't want. Now I might want to flip my Jace. Then I have to discard something. It would probably be a forbidden alchemy. Or this. Oh, I didn't flip the Jace. I probably should have. I mean, I'm discarding good cards here, so I think having one extra loyalty would probably have been better. So I'm not gonna say that it's gonna be super relevant, but it's just the fact that he can't kill it would have been invaluable. Oh wow. I don't want to give him Searsun Dial on land. But this thing is so good. As is this thing. I think this is the most reasonable split. I assume he's going to take the creature and the Searsun Dial. But I think I'll be able to connect with this if he takes that. Oh, it's non-black anyway, so he can't stop this. Do I have two blue? I don't. I need another land. So he took the removal spell, interesting. Well, there you go. Can I kill it? That would be very weird. I think I would rather just have the swamp, I guess. I can play Flower Stone, and yeah, I can't, that doesn't work. It doesn't have red mana. What happens to this? Oh, so he just gains two. But nothing happens to the card. The card stays there. Oh, why did I do this? I hope it I hope he doesn't. I hope that doesn't cost me. So he's drawing a prophetic bolt here, which he can't cast. Oh, maybe that was why he was trying to taint it back for. He was just trying to taint it back for a red land. Is he trying to kill this? Because that won't work. Because it's black. Unless I misread the card, in which case it would work. But yeah, he's probably trying to kill it. Alright, that was good for me. Not a red land. Sorry. So now I get to Factor Fiction? I like that. Wait, what? But he had it already. Because he drew Prophetic Bolt. No, he had it because I gave it to him in Factor of Fiction. Yeah, what am I saying? Yeah, I'm actually kind of running out of time here. I have to play a little bit quicker. Maybe I want the lands, because there's a heathen. I mean, Noyandar would be good, because I have Forbidden Alchemy. And I have Jace. I think I was going to go with the lands. That was a good split though. If you put any land with Noyandar, I would have taken it. Wait, in a combat? No. I think getting lands is not too bad because I have Eternal Dragon. And this is basically 12. Sixth. He's probably gonna kill it now, but I mean, he's gonna kill something at some point. I would rather he just kills the one that comes back. Plus, I get to cast it with this, so. Yeah, that's not that bad for me. I get to cast that. I don't think I'm bringing back my Eternal Dragon this turn. Well, I guess the decision was made for me. So I forgot to set a stop. 15 cards in my graveyard. There's not enough. Wow. I messed up a little bit, but I was planning on charging this anyway, but there is definitely a chance that I want to cycle this instead, so I probably should have a black mana. I have 2 minutes and 45 seconds. All right, that worked.